Welcome back. Today we'll be talking about the following stories: victory in Kentucky, Cap Euro London this weekend, and Obama and UIGEA. The big news out of the US has been the recent court ruling in Kentucky. On January 20th, the Kentucky Court of Appeals blocked the state from seizing 141 iGaming domain names. This domain hijacking attempt dates back to September, and since then, the industry has been working hard to fight the action in court. Big name organizations such as Poker Players Alliance, iMega, and ACLU have invested considerable time and money in this battle. It's not hard to see why this attempted domain hijacking has been taken so seriously in our industry. If it was successful, it would have set a dangerous precedent. Think about it. If one state is allowed to seize control over a property located in another state or country, then other states could do it too. Remember, the internet has no boundaries. So a website based in one country can be accessed by other countries. But if a country wants to block its citizens from accessing a website, it should not be allowed to confiscate that site's domain name. That's unfair to the domain owner and unfair to all the other countries that let people access the internet freely. Unfortunately, last week's ruling doesn't really get into this larger issue. It establishes that domain names are not the same as gambling devices, but it doesn't say that Kentucky overreaches authority. And that's what most lawyers wanted to hear. Still, a victory is a victory, and the state has announced its appeal in the ruling. For now, advantages with the online gambling community. Let's hope this ruling stands. It's that time of the year again. Every January, CAP holds the year's premier iGaming affiliate conference in London. This year's CAP Euro London kicks off tomorrow at the 4-star Novotel London Hotel. The first day will feature the highly anticipated second annual CAP Awards. Be prepared to see a lot of happy faces as we announce the results of months of voting. Who will be announced as this year's top affiliates, programs, and managers? Just a couple more days and they are revealed. The rest of CAP Euro London will be just as exciting. There will be numerous experts and discussion panels specifically designed to help affiliates get the most out of their programs. Some of the panel topics include SEO, email marketing, affiliate payment systems, legal issues, predictions for 2009 from industry executives, and much more. There will also be 5 brand new special sessions focused on the European markets, sponsored by Everest Affiliates. This year's keynote speaker is Susan Kish, a highly successful entrepreneur and online expert. And of course, there's the legendary parties. CAP Euro London is probably just as known for its parties as its great business opportunities. Here's a rundown of what's going on after hours. All this is just the tip of the iceberg. You know that the most memorable moments at CAP Euro are usually the unplanned events. No matter what industry you're in, there's no denying that the biggest story was in the US last week. As President Barack Obama was sworn in, there was a great deal of celebration here. But in the iGaming community, there was one question on everyone's mind. Will President Obama overturn UIGEA? He hasn't made a specific statement on it yet, but the new president's actions so far have indicated that he wants to change the policies followed by the recent Republican administration. We also found out last week that the new Congress is eager to overturn last-minute laws put into effect by the Bush team. This may include UIGEA. However, there may be a roadblock in the form of Obama's new Attorney General, Eric Holder. Holder has close ties to the NFL, which is very opposed to online gambling. He also was once a member of a law firm that lobbied for UIGEA. Holder actually answered yes during his confirmation when he was asked whether he would continue to, quote, aggressively enforce the law against the forms of internet gambling that the Department of Justice considers illegal. That means UIGEA. But all else indicates that Obama is not the kind of leader who would continue these unfair laws. In the meantime, you can add your voice to the crowd by asking to repeal UIGEA. Just go to the website you see on your screen and search for UIGEA. Then click on the Boost America's Economy with Legal Online Poker and you'll go to an online petition. Sign it and help let the president know that the harm that UIGEA is doing. Let's all do our part to help get UIGEA overturned as soon as we can. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next Wednesday with a special Cap Year Old London recap.